Oh. Oh. Hey, y'all. Hey, what's up about that?
It's on fire, pasa limbo.
Let's do it, y'all. Oh, 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 oh. Great band, y'all. What's up, y'all? Hope you had a really good day. So, I know it's late. I'm going to figure out everybody's schedule. You guys are all over the U.S., so I have to figure out. Maybe I'll do one today. Maybe I'll do it tonight. Tonight, I just wanted to do a palette again for. I did a smoky eye. I want to do just kind of something neutral you can do at home. I'm going to get another request for that. Or just every day that you can wear to work, that you don't feel like it's too much, quick and easy. I did do my face already with some man. I'll do another demonstration. I did do some little strobing, as you can see, a little highlight. I did some contouring for the lovely ladies. And again, my makeup, I've got my Addiction 4, number 4 palette. Gonna go in, like I said, not too heavy. You know, I go OD with the strobing and the highlight. It's just, it's the best, the best, the best, the best, the best. Yep. Just inviting a few people, like, hey y'all. Hey, boo. Hey, y'all. Hey, y'all. Hey, y'all. Hey. But yeah, I hope everybody had a really good day. I'm just, you know, doing my thing here. All right. All right, let me go in. Yeah. So again, we got a brush there. I'm going to use this in here. I'm going to start. I'm probably going to do these three colors here. I'm going to do Brave, Arrogant, and Tender to kind of highlight it there. Three colors, not big, not major. I might put a little Honest in there, I don't know. So for my base color, I'm going to go with Arrogant. Alright. And again, like I said, we're going to do windshield wiper. Just kind of get it all up in there. Right. Start from the outer corner. Just come in a little bit. A little bit. I'm not even just what I'm taking here. I'm just gonna move it, push it around. Windshield whopper. But yeah, do that little windshield whopper. Got it on there, just distributing my product. Then I'm gonna turn it this way a little bit because I still got product in. I'm just working it in. I haven't dipped back in the palette at all. And as you can see there already, I told you before, it's very deep pigmented. I probably even still went too much in with the shadow, but just nothing major. Not too far there. Just going in. And as you can see here, this part of my lid here, it's still kind of open, and I'm going to use a lighter color there. And then I'm going to blend it all out so we don't have the harsh lines. And already you see a difference. So just going in with the Arrogant. Again, maybe I'll just do them all. Oh, I already tapped it in the Arrogant, so might as well go ahead. Just do it. Start there. And I'm going to go in with the tip first. Left side for me is always a little bit harder to blend, but I'm working on it. I've seen some people say just kind of hold your hand against something to kind of keep it a little bit steadier. Y'all probably won't have this much of a problem with blending because I am plus size, so my lids are a little bit thicker. Some of you might be a little bit easier there. I did prime my eyes a little bit, and what that does, I use a little bit of concealer, and there's a couple of products I'm waiting for them to come in. I'm going to go ahead and order them so I can show you with everything. Just kind of a whole full look together. It's what it does, it makes it easier to glide on. So when we're doing the windshield wiper lotion, all that is coming in. Just go back in. Just gonna do a gem. Hey, do it y'all. Pulling this crease here, make it kind of look more even. then I'm gonna turn it again, like I said. Oh my God, this left side is a little bit. And it, you know, it practice does take perfect. So if you don't do a lot of shadows, like I said, you don't really need to go super ham with it. Just a little bit there, get it on there, just kind of coat the brush. And like I said, you go on the corners. I need to put lashes. Hey, Kimora, what's up, girl? That's my niece. Hey, I need to put lashes on your tutorial to make the eyes pop out. You right, girl. I'm gonna do a full look. I'm just waiting for some more, I'm waiting for some more product to come in so I can just kind of encompass the whole thing. I'm going to try to do under 20 minutes, just a full face beat. I did this off camera already. I actually did concealer and I did powder. No, I'm lying. I did foundation and concealer. I did the first time I just did that just to get kind of medium coverage. And I did that there. Now, you guys, let me tell you something. There's a lot of talented people up here. I'm just kind of like old school. And what I do is I watch some of the younger ladies that are very talented. Oh, my goodness. They're like artists and so forth. And okay, you see me? I see you too, girl. I try to be like you, girl. But, you know, old school. Let me tell you something. You can always learn from people. There's some ideas, like I said, some of the older ladies that want to still look nice. I want to look age appropriate. Now, my niece, she's beautiful. She's a fierce beauty. Got to give a shout out to Fierce Beauty. Well, she had them wigs tight. She had the wigs tight. Tight, girl. They tight, girl. Don't worry. Auntie going to get, she'll get to my homegirl. I showed her your picture today. And she was like, oh, you got to get me one. She likes the one that you have, but she wants it a little bit shorter. I said, I got you. You got to send me a message on how to take the measurements. You know, I'm not really familiar with that. Okay, so now you see it's a little bit more even. Again, the lids are still there. It's good to go. Now I'm going to go in, take a blending brush. And then, like I said, just go over it. This is a clean blending brush. There's nothing on it. You just want to go in, do that windshield wiper motion. And again, what that does is take out the harsh lines so you don't look like browns here, blues there. You want to have a gradient effect. And you want to make sure it just kind of like blends out there. You don't want to be like, okay, even though you can see where it is, it's darker here and it starts to come out there. And that's what this does here. It's definitely what you want to do. Chica, I really appreciate you coming on and just checking me out there. Yeah, yeah, yeah. Love. Love to my niece. She's got my two great nephews there. They're both, you know, under 6 years old. She got a baby. She got a year coming up there and she's doing her thing. And I tell you, she's just beautiful inside and out. That was actually my first daughter. No, my second daughter. That's my second niece. But they like my daughters. Then Takia was the oldest one. And then Kia came to Anthony, my son, and her actually grew up more like brother and sister than first cousins, which is pretty awesome. Ooh, excuse me. All right, so next I'm going to go in. I'm actually going to do a little bit of Brave. Just kind of up in the crease here a little bit. And what I'm going to do is blend that in on top of the crease there. A little bit with the braid. Tap off. And I, like I said, it's not a lot of fallout, which is really nice. But yeah, a whole bunch of powder. You can like sit up there. Really nice. And like I said, it's a very nice palette there. As you can hear the clip in there with the mirror and so forth. It's very nice. Holds everything nicely, neatly there. We also have the quads with the circles where you can take out the circles of your shadows and customize the palette that you want. So you know, with the seasons getting ready to change, you're going from your summer look into your fall. If you want to have more, you know, of your there, then you got your popping shadow. They have a purple that's out now that's like a hot item. And on the page there, you can definitely see all the items there that go fast and stuff. So again, I'm just blending that out just a little bit. All right, now we're gonna go with the tender, which is the first color here. And I'm actually going to use that on the lid and as well as the brow bone. And I'm taking the second end of the brush there. I call it the Q-tip spongy part. Now, I didn't take a lot, as you can see there, because this product is very pigmented. It's very rich. Let me see you flex them brows like that. I'm going to hook them up. All right, so just tap a little bit there. Just like I said, to get a gradient kind of effect there. Like I said, not a lot. As you can see, it's alright. Oop, that's alright. We'll mix it. Oh, I'm looking in the camera instead of the mirror. Cut down. okay, and then it's gonna go a little bit more, and that's gonna be for the brow to just highlight that, accentuate it. Just kind of give it the gradient effect. I'm gonna blend it out because I don't want to be looking like the raccoon now. Alright, I'm gonna just go back. This way I'm gonna hold it this way. You see it's kind of an angle tip. I'm gonna hold it this way just to blend with this as well. Like I said, to get the gradient effect. The graduated effect. And not to worry. If it's too much and you see there, smoke stack, just go here. Put a little bit and go back. You can always go back. Oh, I touched that there. Go back in and get your product in this way. Because you see there was more on this side but not there, and it looks kind of uneven. But it's better not to have enough than too much, because then you're sitting up there trying to pile on more and then you're going to be looking crazy. Then it's like, why she look like a raccoon? And that won't be cool. So it's still a little bit, it ended up coming out a little bit smoky. I probably should have just did tender and maybe braid, but it's not as smoky as the other one though. Cool. So it looks actually more of a gray, charcoal, smoking kind of. Let me get another brush and lens. Alright. So we've got that palette there. Now I'm going to go in with, I've actually got here, I've got the Epic Mascara and I've got the Esteem Lash Serum. So it's a serum. I'm going to put that on first to kind of set it there. There. This one I'm going to attempt to do in the camera. Today. So it's got a really nice brush there. Just kind of there to get it going. Just get it ready. Looking good. If you don't want to put on lashes, and I know every day you don't want to deal with lashes, or until you can figure out how to, you know, get that going on. Ooh, smells nice. Y'all hear me jamming? Hey. Yeah. So I'm going in with my mascara. I'm going to have to use my nose because I would be sitting up here looking crazy. Ooh, this is nice. Let me put a little bit more serum on there. And what it's doing is just really, like, now that I'm looking at it, it is elongating. So again, it gives the effect of having lashes. Because like I said, every day you just may not want to do that. I put it on the bottom too. On my waterline. I'm perfected, Michelle, because you see already my eye is, I felt myself. And anybody, if you have any suggestions on better as far as that there, go ahead and leave me some comments and let me see what's going on. Ooh, I gotta go back. Ooh. Alright, so. Again, like I said, this is the lash serum. It's really nice. They have the 3D fiber lashes as well too. I'll do another time with that one there. I'm just gonna get some of this. Ooh, it's tearing. Okay, thank you so much, Chica. You have a good night. I see you still have a good night. I know you gotta get up and work. Appreciate you stopping by for a little bit. Love you, love you, baby girl. Not a lot there. There's some good Zumba music. Get some, all right, here we go. So just gonna elongate that. Ooh, y'all, let me tell you something. Look like I'm gonna have some serious lashes. It's just really elongating it. I love it. Because like I said, you don't always want to be putting on lashes. but you definitely want them eyes to pop, 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 pop. Snap, crackle, pop, 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 pop. And I'm just rolling it because there's enough product there. I don't even have to like dip, honestly. I just kind of turned it. So I did first, I did some short strokes. I came over here and then I just came. Ooh, y'all better hush. I'm just trying to get my water line to. Girl, somebody better shut the front door. Look. Yes, child. Mmm. What you talking about? Oh, girl. And you can just. You really could just leave it like that. Not too much, but like I said, just enough. Just enough to kind of get it popping there. Yeah, tell me what you think. Alright, now what I'm going to do is I'm going to use some of this this lip gloss. One of the mamas said, my lip gloss is popping. My lip gloss is shining. Oh, 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 oh. Got a precision lip pencil. So this isn't a color popular. I've got my lip pencil there. And the crazy thing is, I used it once there. It looks that color, but it's well, you'll see. It's kind of lined up there. Because I have full of lips, I go on the inside. I don't really go on the outside unless I'm really trying to get that super popular. Because I already have full lips. But if your lips are not full, or you want more, or you want more of the full kind of look, then go for it on the outside. I'm just going to go a little bit on the inside. And I actually do my lip as well, because I find that it gives a more fuller color. And then once I put it on there, it lasts a little bit longer. You always want to put some type of moisturizer. We do have a lip balm there as well, too. I'm waiting for that to come in. Like I said, I'm going to do a whole look when I have everything kind of come together. I'm going to have it ordered. I have to be careful what I draw. For some reason, my lip comes and it goes in and like an upside down M or something. Hey. Go ahead and line the top. Oh, it did? Oh. Oh no. Well, if I got cut off, I'll come back.